What is it, life? What makes it different from just matter? Everything, living or not, is just chemicals made from atoms. These fish and the water the fish are in are just soups of atoms. But what makes the fish alive and not the water is how the atoms are organized, by a special kind of molecule, and you know this because you learned about it in high school, DNA. The double helix molecule that houses the chemical alphabet of A's and C's and T's and G's, which in different combinations can make a flower, or a frog, or you. Every living creature has its code that makes it grow, reproduce, and change. DNA turns dust into life. And how it does that? Ah, well, now here's the mystery. 20 years ago, scientists learned to read a creature's entire DNA sequence, beginning to end, a genome, it's called. They did this for simple things like bacteria, and then for more complex flies, and eventually for humans. And then they began to tinker, to take the glow from a jellyfish and transfer it to a cat, to make critters do what they'd never done before. And as biologists got better at this, as Stanford professor Drew Endy, a new kind of science was born.
It's called synthetic biology. It's a means to an end.
What can we do with the new tools of synthetic biology? Well, we can improve on what's been spelled out over 3 billion years of evolution. We can take it beyond reading genomes or editing genomes and start writing genomes. Our own ideas of what life should be like, making creatures drastically different from any that have ever existed. And how do you do that? Well, already, one group of scientists have rewritten and rebuilt the entire instruction kit for the very humble little yeast. And they plan to put their new recipe into a cell. And if everything goes according to plan, it will come alive and begin making baby yeast exactly like its most unusual parent. It will be new in the world. This synthetic yeast will break the continuous chain of evolution that links every creature back to the first living cell. It will be discontinuous, in a way, a thing unto itself. And then where do we take this new technology? How far should we, or will we, go?